Hey, Michael with X-Force PC. This has to do with troubleshooting your panels. Now, one thing I've mentioned in other videos and in the printed documentation is if this, on the multi-panel, if the, there's no numbers showing up here, that is a thing with power management. You have to edit the registry and fix it. And it's a one-time thing. It's not something you have to do every time. But you have to basically, you have to turn off power management to that USB port. So if you're not getting anything on the screen, but the panel itself still actually functions, other than just nothing showing on the screen, then you need to look for that documentation or email us and we'll send you the link, or we can remote in and do it for you and so forth. Some other things to talk about for troubleshooting. If any of your panels ever don't come on when you start X-Plane or whatever sim you're flying, just exit and go back in. And hopefully it'll work. If not, do a reboot. And if that doesn't fix it, actually unplug the panel from the powered USB port and plug it back in. Bottom line, these SciTec panels can be finicky. They don't come up 100% of the time. And that's a shame. And that's probably something SciTec could fix. But, you know, they haven't done it. So occasionally you'll fire up X-Plane or Prepared or FSX and one of these panels, you know, any one of them, just decides it's not going to work that time. And so just, you know, exit, go back in, and again, if that doesn't fix it, exit, pull the power or pull the USB out on the hub so it cuts power to the panel, and then plug it back in. And of course, there's also the little SciTec test programs. I usually put them down in the taskbar, but you can also find them in the start menu. And it's just a little test program that'll activate your panels. Now, if you test it and you've got three radio panels, it'll only light up one of them. So it is a little limited there, but that test program allows you to test your, you know, your switch panel and your multi-panel and of course the radio panels. So hopefully that kind of helps. Also, you want to plug the hub. You always want to have these on a powered USB hub because they draw a decent amount of power comparatively to what the USB ports on the computer can put out. So again, you want to use a powered USB hub, and we recommend plugging that into one of the USB 2.0 ports on the computer, and those are black. So if you call SciTec for support, because ultimately, you know, if it's a warranty issue, you know, SciTec handles the warranty on these, they're going to ask you, do you have it plugged into a USB 2.0? And if you say no, then they're going to say, well, call us back when you've got it plugged into a USB 2.0 port. So bear that in mind as well. As far as... That's it.